thank the Lord for spiritual blessings. Because I ain't always had a suit to put on. I ain't always had a collar to drop. There were some times that they were tight in my life, but I thank God that I had a praying mother, a spiritual blessing. She declared, I ain't got a whole lot to give you, but I can give you somebody who's got everything that you need. Her name was Kim. Lord, I mess with you today. Another spiritual blessing. Not only does he talk about the spiritual blessing of knowing the person of him, but knowing the promise of hope. Yes, sir. The promise of hope. Which is, part B is the Holy Spirit. The guarantee. You know, I asked my wife this morning, she didn't know why. Because she used to work for the post office. And I said, baby, when there is a special delivery, is that an eagle on there as their trademark or a dove? She said, I think it's an eagle. You know what you told me?
That's what I told you.
That's what you told me. And so, you know, what I sense in that, she didn't know why I was asking, but I knew. What I sense in that is that the Holy Spirit is our blessed hope. But while we're journeying through this life right now, the Holy Spirit suggests and guarantees that we're going to make it, regardless of what we're going to do. You're going to make it. You got more money, but you're going to make it. You can't find a job yet, but you're going to make it. All you got to do is understand spiritual blessings. Spiritual blessings will speak you along the way. And you don't even know how you're making it. It's because of understanding the spiritual blessing in Almighty God. When you understand the person of Him, and when you understand the promise of hope, who is our guarantee. And not only while I'm hanging out right there with the Holy Spirit, not only while I'm hanging out right there, but not only is the spiritual blessings the person of Him, the promise of hope, but He is the power of help in our lives. What you saying, preacher? Whatever you're going through, there is a help that's available for you. Throw your tissues and your napkins and your handkerchiefs in the trash can. No, stop crying over trivial things. But no, some of us cry and hold our head down so much. God's trying to get your attention. Lift your head up. When I died at Calvary, I sent you some help. All you got to do is understand the spiritual blessing. Stop trying to get stuck all the time, but get the right stuff on the inside and you will be all right. There's a power that's standing and waiting. And guess what? He's standing. He's standing in you. How often do we forget who's in us versus the outside events of the world and of this experience we call life? When Satan shoots his best shot at me, and sometimes he'll make me stagger every now and then, but then I'll call and remember the Holy Spirit. I start getting back up. I turn around and look him in the face. And I'm like, "Oh, are you devil? You think you got me? Well, I got something to that. You might have all of those and the above. The person of him, the promise of hope, the power of help. But if you read the text, and I'm reading it right, it says we can't miss the position and who's the head. Ain't that in your Bible? It's sure in mine. And I think that's why we get off track so often. Because we forget who the head is. Some folk in some churches think they the head. Oh, I'm on the deacon ministry. I'm the chairperson of the deacon ministry. I'm the president of the choir. They think they the head. I didn't come to bust your bubble. I just came to give you the word of God. Jesus Christ is the head.